Hello dear students, welcome to the unit 6 of the foundations of communications and computer networks. In this unit we are going to study about the physical and MAC layer standards and switching. In the beginning, we shall start with the Ethernet standards. So, IEEE has defined the standards for Ethernet at data link layer as well as at the physical layer. So, a little bit history about this particular standards. In 1985, the Computer Society of IEEE started a project. That project was called 802 to set standards to enable intercommunication among equipment from a variety of manufacturers. The project 802 is a way of specifying functions of physical layer and data link layer of major LAN protocol. So these standards now are used in the LAN as a LAN protocols. So what are these standards? The standard was adopted first by NC, that is American National Standard Institute, in 1987. The International Organization for Standardization ISO also approved it as an international standard under the designation ISO 8802. The relationship of the 802 standard to the traditional OSI model is shown in this particular figure. The relationship is like this, that is the IEEE standard, it defines at the physical layer and at the data link layer. At the data link layer, it has got two sub layer, that is LLC and the MAC layer. Whereas various protocols have been defined at the MAC layers, like Ethernet MAC or Token Ring MAC or Token Bus MAC and so on. This LLC stands for Logical Link Control. Whereas at the physical layer also various standards exist, which is Ethernet physical layer, then Token Ring physical layer, Token Bus physical layer and so on. So this is the magnified version of the last diagram. So it shows how the IEEE standard map to the OSI internet model. Let us compare here the HDLC frame with the frames that are the frame format that are specified in the IEEE standard. The HDLC frame defined for the data link layer has the format like this, whereas the format that is specified by IEEE is in this fashion. This is LLC sublayer and MAC sublayer. So LLC sublayer contains DSASP, which is the destination service access point, SSASP, that is source service access point, then control bits and the upper layer data. This LLC defines a protocol data unit that is somewhat similar to the HDLC. The header contains control field like one in the HDLC. The field is used for flow and error control. The two header fields define the upper layer protocol at the source and destination that uses LLC. The MAC sub layer, in other words, the frame defined in HDLC is divided into PDU at LLC sub layer and the frame at the MAC sub layer as shown in the figure. The MAC frame consists of the MAC header and the MAC payload, and these are the FCS, that is error control bits. Let us now first see the standard Ethernet. Basically, the Ethernet has been divided into four, or the Ethernet has undergone four generations, and the first generation is the standard Ethernet. So this is the Ethernet evolution. The first is a standard Ethernet with the speed 10 Mbps, fast Ethernet. So it is it has the 100 Mbps speed. The gigabit Ethernet has got 1 Gbps speed, and the 10 gigabit Ethernet has got 10 Gbps speed. So let us first see this standard Ethernet, and then we shall go to the other types of Ethernet. The format of the frame for the standard Ethernet is in this fashion, as we have already discussed that format, which contains the MAC header. So this is the MAC header, which consists of the destination address, which is 6 byte, source address, again 6 byte, and the length of that particular frame, which is 2 bytes. So it is either length or the type of the frame. Then the actual payload or the data, and padding will be there in case if the data is not sufficient, and CRC, that is cyclic redundancy code, which is of 4 bytes, whereas these 8 bytes, they are the physical layer headers, which consist of the preamble, which is 56 bits. It is alternate bits of ones and zeros, and SFD, that is start frame delimiter. So this is 1 byte, and the byte is like this: 10101011. So immediately after this SFD, that is start frame delimiter, the next byte will be the byte from the destination address. So this is the standard for the 802.3 MAC frame. In this data, number of bytes in the data can be minimum 46 bytes, or it can be maximum 1500 bytes. So the length has to be specified here. So the minimum length has to be 46 bytes. So this 46, if the minimum payload is 46 bytes, then the minimum length of the frame will be 64 bytes. As we add the remaining byte, that is the MAC header and the CRC bit, if we add, then it becomes 64 bytes. Okay. In the case if the payload is maximum, that is 1500 bytes, then the length of the frame, in which case the frame will be maximum, so maximum frame length will be 12,144 bits, or 1518 bytes. So the frame length, minimum frame length can be 64 bytes, or the maximum frame length can be 1518 bytes. Now let us see how is the source address or the destination address in the MAC layer frame. The as it has specified, its length is 6 bytes, and it is the 6 byte hexadecimal number. Usually it is specified as 6 byte the hexadecimal number, and that address is called the physical address. Popularly it is known MAC address or the physical address, and it has got 12 hexadecimal digits. So a typical address is 06 01 02 01 2 C 4 B. So total number of bits are 48 bits in that address. The address, it can be either unicast address or the multicast address. If it is unicast address, then in the first byte LSB bit is 0. LSB bit 0 in the byte 1 of the address indicates that the address is unicast address, whereas the byte 1 LSB bit 1 indicates that it is a multicast address. Multicast address means that it is meant for more than one destination. So the least significant bit of the first byte defines the type of address. If that bit is 0, the address is unicast, otherwise it is the multicast address. So if the broadcast destination address is a special case, multicast address in which all bits are 1. So if all bits are 1, then it is the broadcast destination address. So let us see one example here. Define the type of the following destination addresses. So three addresses are given here, and we have to find out whether it is unicast, multicast or broadcast address. So what is the solution for this? To find the type of address, we need to look at the second hexadecimal digit from the left, okay, or the first byte LSB. So if it is even, the address is unicast. If it is odd, the address is multicast. If the all digits are F, the address is broadcast. Therefore we can see that in case of A, the this particular second hexadecimal digit is A, which is 1010, and the LSB is 0, so it is unicast address. In case of the second address, the LSB of the first byte, lower 4 bits, they are 7, so the LSB is 1, that is, this is a multicast address. Whereas the C address, you can see that all bits are FFFF, that is converted to binary, they are all 1, so it is a broadcast address. Let us see another example as to how these particular addresses are sent out on the line. So this particular example shows how the bits will be, how this address will be sent bit by bit. So the procedure to send the address is like this, or the procedure to send the bits in a frame is like this. The address is sent left to right, so that is from left to right. So this byte will be sent first, then this byte, then this byte, and like that. Okay, then in each, for each byte, it is sent right to left bit by bit as shown in the figure below. So 47 will be sent first, but the bits in the 47 will be sent from right to left now. So if we convert this 47 into binary, it will be 0100 0111. So it will be sent in this fashion, that is, you can say, see that if I write like this, 1110, so that is 7, then 0010, so that is 4. So it is 0100 and 0111, so that is 47. Then 20 will be sent. How 20 will be sent? 0010 and 0000. So this is how 20 is sent. Then 1B, so it is 0001 1011, so it is 1B. So like that the remaining bytes are sent on the line. The if we see at the physical layer, the IEEE specifies different types of the standards. The first standard is 10 base 5, so it is a bus and it uses a thick coaxial cable, whereas the second standard is 10 base 2. So again, it is a bus standard, it is a bus and it uses a thin coaxial cable. The next standard, physical layer standard, Ethernet standard, is 10 base T. It uses a star topology and it is twisted pair, the unshielded twisted pair, whereas 10 base F uses the star topology and it uses the fiber optics. So this is the encoding in the standard Ethernet implementation. So Manchester code is used for encoding the bits. So the 10 base 5 implementation is like this. The 10 base 5, the name is, it comes from this. 10 stands for 10 Mbps, base, it stands for the baseband, that is digital, and 5 indicates the length of that particular LAN, which is 500 meter. So the length of this particular LAN can be 500 meter. So you can see here that in this particular LAN, this is the thick coaxial cable whose maximum length can be 500 meter, and there are T at this particular coaxial cables which connects the terminals or the machines in the LAN, and there is a cable end. You can see the cable end at both ends of this particular LAN. So this is the 10 base 5 implementation. Then the next one is 10 base 2 implementation. So in this case, the 2 here is approximately 200 meter, so it is actually 185 meter, but approximately 200 meter. The change here is that the length, of course, it is 185 meters, and this particular coaxial cable is thin cable, and you can see that unlike the thick coaxial cable, which cannot be folded or it is not flexible, whereas this particular thin coaxial cable is flexible. But the problem here is that the distance, the length of this particular cable, it can be limited to 200 meter only. Then next implementation is 10BASE-T. So here it uses a twisted pair, and the topology used is the star topology. So for that purpose it uses an hub, and that particular hub has got different the number of ports, and each of the terminal is connected by using two pairs of unshielded twisted pair cable. So this is how is 10BASE-T implemented, whereas this is the implementation for 10BASE-F. So here F stands for the fiber optic cable. So here you can see that this is 10BASE-F hub, and the terminals, they are connected using the two fiber optic cables. So this is the summary of the standard Ethernet implementation. So we shall shortly resume with the remaining part of this particular lecture.